Hi, I'm Richard Chambry. This is Rich Photo Books. This is a sequence of photo vlogs that I'm making about my photo books, hopefully giving a little bit of inspiration or recommendations for people to go and purchase them, whether you're starting out in photography or you are already established. Today's book is Tony Ray Jones, which is a book I got on my 21st birthday from my mentor, Jeff Pick. When I was working at the Hearts and Essex Observer, he got me into Tony Ray Jones and Henri Cartier-Bresson and all the other street photographers and amazing photographers out there of the time. This is one of the books. So R.O.P. Jeff Pick, thank you very much for that. It's a book, as you can see, it's quite knackered and it's well thumbed, okay? The reason for this is Tony Ray Jones was fantastic and he died way too young. He died age 30. In 1972, all his contemporaries were the magnum photographers of the day, and he'd gone to New York, he'd worked really hard and wanted to push forward with his photography and his photojournalism. He was a real new, amazing name that was about to project itself onto the world properly, and over a period of time would have done had he not been diagnosed with leukemia, and unfortunately that was all cut short. So it's quite a sad story about what happened to Tony. I really recommend that you go get this book. It is fantastic. There are other Tony Ray Jones books knocking around as well. I went this year to an exhibition that was put on by Martin Parr at the Science Museum. That was fantastic. I think there's a book attached to that. I will go and do a little bit of research and I'll put some links underneath this video. So let's start flicking through, because if you haven't heard of Tony Ray Jones before, you probably have seen his photographs. More than certainly would have seen his photographs. They are used quite extensively. And, you know, other photographers refer to him as a real influence, rightly so, because he was brilliant. The way that he looked at imagery and photography, the way that he composed, and especially he was into looking through things, looking around things and past things in his composition. So that, for me, that was hugely influential. These images are taken in this book particularly, or a 10-year sort of 61-ish to his death, 71, 72. So you've got a good 10-year spread of his photography. It's in the post time of The Americans being published, the Robert Frank book. You know, as I said, Tony Ray Jones had gone to America and he'd photograph it. I really love it, you know, his American photography. Especially, he managed to really capture the people and their patriotism. This is back in the UK. You would have seen this image. It's used a lot on picture postcards and posters and so on. He had a great way of capturing the British. The British were still in their shoes and socks and trousers on the beach. That was when I was growing up. And managed to capture a culture of, you know, the British, we are a little bit of an eccentric bunch of people. And there's some great photography to be had here. If you're not from Britain and you want to come visit, come and photograph it. People are fantastic. And Tony Ray Jones captured society and culture at its best. You know, he's such a great photographer for that. They're capturing the moment and capturing the establishment of its time as well. Let's get over this page. There's some great stuff up here. There you go. The quality of his photography is really good. Everything is like pin sharp. Also, his processing and post-production printing is really fantastic. You know, that doesn't get mentioned a great deal. He had a real he was able to really keep the quality. He was obviously mattered to him. You can see Here, you would have seen this image as well. This has been used on a lot of posters and postcards. And, you know, just his eye working around people, around an event, something that is also happening around the people. So as a street photographer or a photojournalist, you know, he really is somebody that, if you've been unaware of him, go and look at his work, go and study him, and go and have a look at his composition. I'm going to finish with this image here. That's plate 70. This is in San Francisco, which is brilliant, which I love. So, you know, this book dots around from New York back to the UK, back to America, a bit of Philadelphia, down into Florida, and back to the UK again, photographing galas and weird events and that kind of thing in the UK. So, as I said, it's definitely worth getting hold of this book. If you've not heard of Tony Rain Jones before, I'll put up a bunch of links underneath this video. Go and click, go and have a look, because he was brilliant. And you'll learn so much from it, as I have done. If you'd like to follow me on social media, I do put these videos out all over the place. I spread it out a little bit so you're able to catch up on other social platforms. I primarily use Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and a bit of Snapchat. So if you'd like to follow me on those, you'll always pick up these videos. And you could go and subscribe to my YouTube channel right now underneath this video if you're on YouTube. And just click subscribe and you'll just pick these vlogs up all the time. There's quite a lot of vlogs there giving recommendations and reviews of books. So if you'd like to go and pick and choose from there, you'll see photographers that you might be interested in and that kind of thing there. It might give you push you in the right direction to go and purchase a book yourself. So thanks ever so much for watching, and get subscribing on my channel. Thanks very much.